Hello students, welcome to Affairs Cloud. My name is Vikas. So friends, we have an application by the name Careers Cloud, which you can go and download through the Play Store. And once you have downloaded, you can log in with your Gmail ID. And why I'm suggesting you this application, because this is the one-stop solution for all the current affairs. This is the best of the best application and the platform where you can enhance your learning through help. Here you will be provided with multiple courses. Here you will be provided with multiple options of quizzes. And even you here you will be provided current affairs on daily basis. PDFs and quizzes will be provided to you on daily basis, both in Hindi as well as English. Here you will be provided current affairs with weekly basis and monthly basis also. Here remember, once you have done watching our video, then you can log in through this application, take out the PDF, read that PDF and go through the quizzes. That will enhance your preparation. Same you have to do for weekly and same you have to do for the monthly also. In monthly, you will be provided with the top 100 important questions PDF and video also that will enhance your learning, and it will be a very benefit and beneficial and important video for the revision perspective. And not just this, friends. Apart from this, we also provide you banking and economic questions. We provide you state current affairs such as of Uttarakhand, UP, Tripura, Telangana and many more. Not just this, apart from this, we also provide you topic wise current affairs, and the topics that we are providing you are really important. These topics are such as national affairs, international affairs, important days, sports, defense, science and technology, apps and web portals, obituary. These are the important topics that are being asked in various exams across India. So these are the topics that are must and should be covered and will be beneficial for the preparation of the students. So friends, I'll highly suggest you to watch our video, as they will be very beneficial for you in the long.
Hello everyone. So in this video, we will be discussing important current affairs of 7th and 8th of May. The session will be very important and interesting. So do pay attention till the end, as you will be learning multiple things from this video. Correct? So let's start. First is Agni Daman. This is the name of the exercise that was recently conducted at what location? Right? We are talking about Agni Daman 23. Right? It is a civil military agency's combat fight. Right? Agni Daman. This exercise was conducted to raise awareness and training of men on firefighting at 29 Field Ammunition Depot, that is in which location? It is in Pune, Maharashtra. Correct? So Agni Daman, this exercise was conducted where? In Pune, Maharashtra. This exercise showcased the teamwork of all the firefighting resources available with the military and civil establishment in Pune. The reason is because of the extremely high temperature conditions in and around Pune have severely increased the fire hazard factor. So in order to overcome this disastrous situation, this exercise was held, which utilized the capabilities of combined forces of all the agencies, including military and civil, to combat fire together. Correct? So it was held in Pune, Maharashtra. Here you can see exercise Agni Daman, civil military agencies combat training exercise. Here you can see all the fire fighters, all they are there and they are trying to basically fire out a particular piece of fire that was going on. Next, and the reason is also simple, that because of the high temperature, and we know El Nino will be striking Odisha soon, and because of it, the temperatures in India and especially in the areas such as Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, or even we can say except hill stations in India, all other states will be facing high temperatures. Correct? And because of the high temperature, we know there is a high chance of forest fires and fire, normal fires also. And in order to take care of those fires, this exercise was conducted. Next, EMJAY. What is this EMJAY? EMJAY. EMJAY control system, they signed an MOU with which organization to manufacture electrochemical bollards. So remember, it is your Bharat Electronics Limited, BEL. They have signed a memorandum of understanding with EMJAY Control Systems. This MOU was signed basically to manufacture and develop business of state of the art electromechanical bollards for use in the various defense, homeland security, paramilitary and expert projects, right? Some of the key features of these bollards are that this bollard would safeguard vital installations by preempting the unauthorized entry of heavy vehicles. The bollards are built to withstand the impact of IED, that is your improvised explosive device. The company designed the bollards indigenously, agreeing with the government with Make in India and Atmanirbhar Bharat policies. Correct? And what is bollard? If you should know also, it is a sturdy short vehicle vertical post which is installed to control the road traffic and prevent automotive vehicles from colliding or crashing into pedestrians and structures. If we talk about BEL, Bharat Electrical Limited, it is a Navratna PSU. Chairman and Managing Director here is Bhanu Prakash Srivastav. Headquarter is in Bangalore, Karnataka, and it was established in 1954. Here you can see BEL, they signed MOU with MJ Control Systems, and it is basically to manufacture electromechanical bollards. Next, Union Government constitutes a 11-member committee to restructure 94-year-old ICAR. What is ICAR? Indian Council of Agriculture Research. So, Union Government, they formed a 11-member committee, and this was under the chairmanship of Additional Secretary of the Department of Agriculture, Research and Education and Secretary of ICAR to restructure the 94-year-old ICAR to meet the objective of Amrit Kal. Correct? Here Amrit Kal is referred as the next 25 years to make India fulfill the aspirations of youth, self-reliance and economic stability. This committee was formed on 24th of April and they have to submit their report within 30 days. Correct? Also remember, earlier the Union Government constituted the committee under Dr. M.S. Swaminathan and Dr. R.A. Mashlekar. However, their recommendation was never implemented. Now, the former Vice Chancellor of Tamil Nadu Agriculture University and a member of ICAR, Dr. K. Ramaswamy, will also recommend restructuring of ICAR. Correct? So these are your important, remember, question can be asked that Union Government constituted 11 member committee to restructure ICAR. If we talk about ICAR, it was formed in July 1929. Currently, there are 111 institutes and 71 agricultural universities under ICAR, and it is counted among the largest national agriculture systems in the world. Next, transactions by CA and CS for clients are now under the ambit of money laundering law. I repeat, the Union Ministry of Finance notified the changes in the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, widening its ambit to include the financial transactions that are facilitated by the company's chartered accountant or company secretaries and the cost and work accounts. Correct? Following the changes, the financial transactions by these professionals, including operating and managing their clients' firms and trusts and buying and selling business entities, will now be covered under the anti-money laundering law. Correct? Directly remember this. Next, where will be Asia's largest biogas plant set up? So remember, Asia's largest biogas plant, it will be set up where? It will be set up in Mumbai, and it will be basically to treat 1000 tons of wet waste daily basis. Alright, on daily basis. So question can also be asked, what is the production limit of this? So of this biogas plant, that is the Asia's largest bio plant, it will be basically, it will be working on to treat 1000 tons of wet waste daily, and this will be set up in Mumbai, Maharashtra. Also remember BMC, that is Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation, and Mahanagar Gas Limited, that is MGL. These two organizations came together and they are joining hands to set up Asia's largest biogas plant in Mumbai, Maharashtra. This proposed plant will recycle damp, organic and degradable waste, which accounts for 3500 tons of the 6000 tons of solid waste generated on daily basis in Mumbai, Maharashtra. Correct? Here you can see BMC and MGL, they together partner to set up Asia's largest biogas plant in Mumbai to treat 1000 tons of wet waste daily. Next is international affairs, GRFC 2023. Here people are facing acute hunger in 58 food crisis countries, and that data has risen to 258 million in 2022. So remember, the flagship publication of the Global Network Against Food Crisis, that is GNAFC, they released a report, Global Report on Food Crisis 2023, and it estimated that nearly 258 million people in 58 food crisis countries or territories will face acute food insecurity in future also at crisis or worse level in 2022. All right, and the people who are suffering or basically who are facing hunger are up from 193 million people in 53 countries and territories in 2021. Earlier it was 193 million people, all right, but now we can see the data is rising and it has risen to 258 million people who are having acute hunger crisis. This is the highest number in the 7 year in history, and you can see the various factors can accumulate for this. One can be your war, then economic crisis that is going on. Second is your refugees. Then we can see that the global trade is hampered, and because of this the prices of various commodities has risen up, that is we say that there is high inflation in those areas. Correct? So because of these are the some factors due to which we are seeing that multiple countries and almost 258 million people are facing acute hunger. Next, which organization launched PRET initiative to be better prepared for future pandemics? So remember, it was your WHO, that is your World Health Organization. They launched a new initiative, that is PRET initiative, that is preparedness and resilience for emerging threats. I repeat, preparedness and resilience for emerging threats. And this was launched to ensure the world is prepared for future outbreaks like COVID-19 pandemics. The initiative aims to help world countries by providing guidance on integrated planning for responding to respiratory pathogens and their recovery by supporting to strengthen the system and capacities. Correct. This PRET initiative was announced at the Global Meeting for Future Respiratory Pathogens Pandemic that was held in Geneva, Switzerland from 24 to 26th of April. Correct. A collection of actions that countries will be expecting to act on with the progress being achieved by December 25 will be described in the PRET monitoring framework. Correct. If we talk about WHO, it was established in 1948. Director General is Tedros Ghebreyesus and the headquarters is in Geneva, Switzerland. Right. If we talk about UNEP, Nairobi, Kenya is the headquarter. For UNDP, the headquarter is in New York. And for IMF, it is your Washington, D.C. Next, you can see WHO launched PRET initiative. And what is PRET? PRET stands for Preparedness and Resilience for Emerging Threats. Next. Here you can see it is a collection of framework that countries will be expected to act on with the progress being achieved by December 2025 will be described in the PRET monitoring framework. Next is related to your banking and finance. Bharat Pay, they have rebranded multi-brand loyalty program buyback payback with India as zillion. I repeat, and this is important, do take a note. BharatPay Group, that is a fintech startup, they have announced the rebranding of its loyalty program, that is Payback India, the most brand loyalty program to Zillion. The new web address for the Zillion here will be zillionrewards.in. The new brand identity is in line with BharatPay's vision to make Zillion ubiquitous to loyalty and rewards across India. Also, Zillion aims to target customers across age groups and add a new dimension to their overall shopping experience across categories and brands. Correct? So it is the Zillion now, right? Next, also one of the most important current affairs for today, that who is the world's highest paid athlete for 2022? He will be a footballer, right? And Cristiano Ronaldo is the correct option, right? And apart from this, he plays for which club right now? He is playing for a Saudi Arabian football club, that is Al Nassr. And remember, there is a high chance, and there was news also that Lionel Messi was also offered one of the highest ever fees for playing for Saudi Arabian football club Al Nassr. And it is expected that if the deal goes, then he will become the highest paid athlete in the world. If we look at some of the players, like Cristiano Ronaldo is on the top, Lionel Messi is on the second position, Kylian Mbappe, he is from France, he is on the third position, LeBron James, he is a basketball player and he is on the fourth position. If we talk about Cristiano Ronaldo, he is from Portugal, Lionel Messi is from Argentina, Kylian Mbappe, he is from France, and LeBron James, he is from USA. Correct? And we know both Rohit Sharma and Virat Kohli, they are cricketers, not footballers, and they are from India. Correct? Next, here you can see footballer Cristiano Ronaldo has topped the Forbes World 10 Highest Paid Athletes 2023 list, and he is playing for Saudi Arabian football club Al Nassr. He earned $136 million via $46 million on-field and $90 million off-field earnings. Here you can see all the list here and their earnings also. Moving on, two Andhra Pradesh student got NASA recognition. I repeat, two Andhra Pradesh student got NASA recognition. And we know NASA is the space agency of USA, and the two students here, Vijayawada in Andhra Pradesh, has been named Sai Akshara Vemuri and Akarsh Chiteni from India under 19 team. They have won the social media category award at NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge for 2023 competition. Correct? That was held in USA only. So coming back, remember which are the two individuals here we are talking about. They have won, they are part of the under 19 team, and they have won the social media category award at the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge 2023 competition. And where this was held? This was held in Alabama, USA itself. Here, this social media award recognized the team's exceptional communication skill and efforts to involve and educate the public on the STEM activities, and STEM starts for science, technology, engineering and mathematics. Next is Russian poet Maria Stepanova has received the 2023 Leipzig Book Award for European Understanding. I repeat, who has been awarded with the Leipzig Book Award for 2023 European Understanding? She is Maria Stepanova, right? And she was awarded for her volume of poetry entitled, that is, Girls Without Clothes, right? And she received this award on 26th of April in 2023 during the opening ceremony of the 30th edition of the Leipzig Book Fair that was held in Leipzig, Germany. Right, if we talk about this Leipzig Book Prize, remember, this Leipzig Book Prize for European Understanding has been awarded annually since 1994, and it is one of the most important literacy prize of Germany. The award is presented every year during the official opening of the Leipzig Book Fair, and this year in 2023 it was the 30th edition. Correct? And this is to those people those intellectual and for their literary work, those have made outstanding contribution to mutual understanding in Europe, particularly with the countries of Central and Eastern Europe. This award comes with a prize money of 20,000 euros. A grand prize and a recognition prize were awarded until 2004, but not now. The inaugural winners of the Leipzig Book Award 1994 were, as you can see here, correct? Because it was initiated, this was the first edition that were presented to them. And the 30th edition, you need to remember, that is for 2023. She is, who has been awarded here? Maria Stepanova. Next, South Asian American author Fatima Asghar has won the inaugural Carol Shields Prize for Fiction. I repeat, South Asian American author Fatima Asghar, a South Asian American poet and a screenwriter, has won the inaugural Carol Shields Prize for Fiction. I repeat, she has won the inaugural Carol Shields Prize for Fiction for her debut novel, that is When We Were Sisters. This is the name of the novel for which Fatima Asghar has won the Carol Shields Prize, and it is the inaugural, that means it is the first edition of the award. Apart from this, $150,000 cash prize was received by her, and the Carol Shields Prize for Fiction is a new English language literary award. And question can be asked, when was this first edition of this award held? It was in the year 2023. Correct, and it is to basically celebrate creativity and excellence in fiction by women. Next is related to sports. Doha Diamond League 2023 was held, and Neeraj Chopra here won the gold medal with 88.67 meter throw. Right, Golden Boy, he is also known by the name Golden Boy. He is from Haryana, and he is related to which sport? Javelin throw. And recently, he has won the gold medal in the Doha Diamond League 2023 by throwing 88.67 meter. Correct. Next, FIDE World Championship 2023 was held, and Ding Liren became the China's first male world chess champion. Important, who became the China's first male world chess champion? He will be Ding Liren, right? He became during the 17th world chess champion, and the Chinese grandmaster Ding Liren has become the 17th world chess champion and China's first male world champion by defeating Russia's at the FIDE World Chess Championship that was held in Kazakhstan. Right, if we talk about this Diamond League, this was initiated in 2010, and Diamond League is an annual series of athletic meets comprising tags and field events organized by Monaco headquarters World Athletics. Correct, and this year who has won this, or we can say the 17th world champion or world chess champion or China's first male world chess champion, he will be Ding Liren. He is 32 years of age. Next is books and authors. Borya Majumdar released a new book titled Sachin at 50, Celebrating a Maestro. Borya Majumdar, a renowned sport historian and a TV show host, she has released a book that is Sachin at 50, Celebrating a Maestro. This book was published by Simon and Schuster India on the occasion of Indian former international cricketer Sachin Ramesh Tendulkar on his birth anniversary, that was on 24th of April, and it was his 50th birth anniversary. The book has been conceptually designed and curated by Majumdar with a special back cover noted penned by the Gulzar sir. Coming back, remember who authored this book or who released this book, Sachin at 50, Celebrating a Maestro? Borya Majumdar. Next, when do we observe International No Diet Day? So we can say this is a cheat day, correct? So that on this day we won't be following any diet. So when do we observe International No Diet Day? This day is observed on 6th of May, right? INDD, International No Diet Day, observed on 6th of May to promote body positivity, self-acceptance and the acceptance of all the body shapes and size, as well as raise awareness about the dangers of heavy dieting. Correct, and the symbol is light blue ribbon here. It is the symbol for International No Diet Day. Correct. Next, when do we observe International Leopard Day? International Leopard Day is also observed on 3rd of May, and it is to raise awareness about the leopards and their plight as well as the risk that the leopard population face. Next, Buddha Purnima. On 5th of May, we observed Buddha Purnima, right? And it is based on the Hindu calendar. Buddha Purnima is annually observed on the Purnima, that is the full moon, in the month of Vaishakh, which usually corresponds to April or May in the Gregorian calendar. Buddha Purnima 2023 falls on 5th of May. And this day is the birth anniversary of Siddhartha Gautama, the founder of Buddhism. Or we can say this is the birth anniversary of Buddha. Correct? Next, if we talk about Gautam Buddha. Gautam Buddha was born where? He was born in Lumbini. Correct? Mark this. Where was he born? He was born in Lumbini. Where did he got enlightenment? At Bodh Gaya. Right? Enlightenment. Where? Bodh Gaya. Next. So friends, these were your important current affairs for the day. Now let's go for a quick revision. Exercise Agni Daman. This was a civil military agency exercise that was held in Pune, Maharashtra. Bharat Electrical Limited signed an MOU with MJ Control Systems to manufacture electromechanical bollards. Union government constituted an 11-member committee to restructure the 94-year-old ICAR. Transactions by CA and CS for clients are now under the ambit of money laundering law. BMC and MGL, they have partnered to set up Asia's largest biogas plant in Mumbai to treat 1,000 tons of wet waste daily. GRFC 2023, people are facing acute hunger in 58 food crisis countries. They have risen to 258 million in 2022. Earlier it was around 140, but now we can see the data has risen to 258 million. WHO, World Health Organization, launched PRET initiative to be better prepared for future pandemics.
That's all for the day, friends. I hope you enjoyed the session, and you can follow us on the YouTube channel, as well as apart from YouTube channel, you can go and follow us at Affairs Cloud Telegram channel. And if you have any queries related to the content or the of courses offered to you or the payment which you did on the application, you can contact us on the number provided, that is 7677333862. Apart from this, friends, you can follow us on the Facebook as well as on Instagram handle, that is affairscloud_official. In the end, friends, if you use a code, that is Vikas10, you will be getting an additional extra 10% discount by using this code Vikas10. Also, if you have any problem regarding the course purchase, any problem regarding to our application, you can contact us on the mobile number, that is 9677333862. And if you want to mail us, you can also mail us on support@affairscloud.com. And I assure you that our representative from us will be contacting you soon and resolving your issue.